Stanford University.
A very complex structure like the head or the brain is very difficult to describe with just a single equation. And so the way we do it is we chop it into geometrically simple structures. So you can think of them as bricks or tetrahedra, triangles.
The finite element method allows us to reconstruct the true geometry of any structure that we want to study. And the underlying idea is that you take medical images, for example, of the true organ, and you cut it into small, tiny pieces that you can then represent on the computer to simulate its behavior.
So it allows us to really look into the brain, so we can take the different pieces of it apart and look at each and every one of them and study how they respond to changes in the mechanical environment, to physical changes, to an impact. This allows us to really study everything in very tiny detail. One of the procedures that's performed on the brain is called decompressive craniectomy. And that's a very ancient procedure. It's more than 100 years old. So when the brain is swelling and responds to a concussion, it can't go anywhere. And so then what surgeons do is they cut out a piece and allow the brain to bulge outwards. So our methods seek to understand this procedure better and improve it by putting quantitative thought into it, by really explaining what is happening during this procedure, what are the deformations that the brain sees, what are the strains and stretches that the axons see, what is the pressure, what are the stresses.
We can look at different locations of these openings, we can vary size, and then very schematically look how that affects the brain on the inside. We see very characteristic differences that are very helpful to the medical doctor to make a more informed decision of where to place the cut and how big the cut should be.
This method is actually generic enough so that we can apply it to other procedures, more complex procedures, just to really guide the surgeons and give them quantitative numbers that are based on real physical analysis of the brain that allow them to really make informed decisions when they treat a patient.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.